Shane, Senior, Monica Cohill, Dr. Oli, Miranda, Chris, Miranda, Mokta, Adele, Nikki, Okay, and of course, Jenny, Sandra, Hami, On, Sipukai. I'm absolutely delighted because I'm also the popularly known as the African Wonder Woman. And many of you have always asked me what I do. And frankly speaking, sometimes I even forget to introduce myself. I'm a motivational speaker. I am a community change maker and builder. I own my own TV show, problem solver, entrepreneur, and of course, I love the social impact in our community. What I love most is to bring people to their best, to do what they were meant to be doing in their whole world, bring a sense of passion in the whole world. And I love abundance and gratitude. My passion is working with the community, and I love to embrace this with all kinds of people and to where they are in their lives. I love for people to bring the best. And of course, my areas of community development has a community scientist. I'm actually a social scientist by background. I'm also a model, for those who don't know. I'm also a politician as well. I stood as a councillor in the borough of Tollington. My opposition candidate was Catherine West, and I gave her a good run when we were doing the campaign a few years back as a candidate. I love to embrace with all kinds of people, and my areas of community development goes all in hand with peace, safeguarding children, bringing improved security in this world, health and well-being, inclusion and promoting health and wellness, improving persons with disabilities, sports, mentoring, capacity building, coaching and training, promoting leadership, gender, microfinancing, and many, many other things that people love. Fashion and design is something that I love. Social justice is something that I love as well. And of course, making a difference to this world. Thank you so much to all of you here today. You are absolutely brilliant. And I'd love to leave you with a story before I even give you your quick comments. When you're in the sports field, this is a story I've told every day. When you just are about to race, you know, I used to race in that field. And when you're just about to race, they say, "Onto your marks, get set, and ready," and you run. So just remember, as long as you've got into that field, you're a winner. And there's only one winner here today, and I wish you all success. I love you all for that. So my comments here tonight is going to go for, I'll start off with Val, and Val, you were quite amazing here tonight. I really loved your story, the way you told it as a person, and how as a child, how we should love children and how adults should go back as children. I love the passion that you bring in as volunteering for children. Your passion with children was not missed at all. And of course, as Jenny said earlier on, the child Shani said, softly spoken, I felt that in you. A healer, and of course, I put down here, you allow children to grow best here, and I felt that in you here tonight. Very well spoken and very well presented here tonight. So I love that you're teaching children great, and you related to the audience as well. And of course, you are seeking to engage with all of us and reminded us how important it is for us to just remind us how to go back into our own childhood presence. So your presentation was there, really, really great. Dr. Sunny Ahonsi, there is hope after the adversity. I felt that you were very educational here tonight, and I felt that there is the sense of you were asking us to go and find our purpose in life. How many would like to be appreciated in their purpose of life? You asked the question. And of course, you explained to us the idea of persistence in whatever you were seeking to achieve. You had the ability and willingness to help others, and that really came across, engaged the audience greatly. And let me share you my journey, or your journey experiences you told us here today. You engaged the audience here today, and you, of course, you left us with great hope. And you also explained that you embraced the difficulties. You explained to us we should embrace the difficulties, how we should overcome that in life. Thank you so much, Dr. Sunny Akonsi, and that was really great. Great presentation of slides as well. That was amazing. And now, Olaulu Jimmy Asuni, there was a difference. And I love, you're the author of Dare to Be Imperfect. What a beautiful title that you give us. I felt that it is thoughtful, consistent, and of course, I love the pace of your presentation. Very, very inspiring, I felt. Colorful, so just like Lily said. Thank you so much for embracing and championing issues to do with disability. How you find out how you were different was absolutely a touching story here tonight. And that reminded me that you scored 6 goals. And I thought, I saw that smile in your face when you scored that 6th goal. It brought a sparkle in the audience here today. Quite engaging. And of course, I felt the chill go down into myself. I felt a sense of sport in you. And as you best described it here tonight, a sense of inspiring all of us to also think about people with disability and never to give up because of the conditions that can limit people or communities. I loved the bodmas of success and how you put it, what life is all about. And you began in saying, believing in yourself and organize your priorities. I love how you finished it by saying, never judge a book of its cover. Your dream is yours. Beautifully saved. And finally, I just want to thank Alpato Pupo, I hope I've said your name, right, all the way in Peru. I loved your icebreaking here tonight. You started us off with a very great icebreaker. Beautiful colors that you chose here today. Well thought through. I loved how you started with to construct. And you reminded us that life is all about happiness. And you asked us to think about that. You have to construct your own happiness, you said. I loved how you said that. My happy place is the stage, you told us here tonight. So I just felt that you presented beautifully and you were on stage and you were consistent, engaging, great pace of speaking, great slides here tonight. And although you said English was not your first language, you presented beautifully. And I loved how you encouraged us to speak about happiness all throughout and to share that. And of course, you brought in the meaning of love. I thank you all for listening here tonight, and I love you all. And my name's again, Juliet Mahapila, African Wonder Woman. I got my TV show, and I'm gonna be writing all about you. So if you're interested, do give me a shout at JNM1000 Talk Shows. Thank you so much. Harry, back to you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Juliet. That was amazing. And our next